I am God. Yes, hello. I will practice you. Say hello. But they're never going to know it. No matter how much you say hello. Say, I am God. Yes, hello, 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 hello. Oh. They'll never understand that you are God, so they'll never understand the actual danger you present. I'm actually a cheerful person. And there are people who, when they see a cheerful person, they don't see it. It couldn't be cheerful. You must be wicked. To be happy, you must be nasty and evil. Mm-hmm. You couldn't just be happy. Because they're not happy, ever happy, do you know? They're angry, or maybe they're in fear. There was the same storyline in fairy tales for probably centuries. And if you look over the fairy tales from all around the world, every land, they're the same. Excuse me for carrying on like this, but there's the sweet man, the lovely, gentle girl or brother or son, girl or son. And then they have the stinky brothers and the nasty people. And the stinky brothers and the nasty people are just simply selfish. There's nothing very much more complex than that. And the good people aren't, they're not. So stinky people go out into the world to get their fortune or to get the princess or to... Or they just are stumbling in the woods and they get lost or whatever. And they run into always a special person. They run into a magical person who always looks like crap. You know, he looks like his nose and the little warts, and they look like witches, and they're crippled and they're awful and they're disgusting. And they need something. What do they need? They just need some food, some liquid, some water, some milk, something. And then stinky brothers and the stinky sisters will not give it to them. And they carry on, and they never succeed. And the nebbish one, the sweet one, who's good-hearted, that's all we know. He's tender-hearted, but everybody makes fun of him, and everybody doesn't treat him very well, because he doesn't scare anybody. This reminds me of me. Must have, can't have. This is humans, nothing to do with the order of the universe. Humans must have what they can't have. They must. They must. You know, one of the ways to get a girl is you're loving your nice, loving your nice, and then you vanish. Exactly. Now they must have you. Anyhow, this man is suicidal, and he's an actor, and he's terribly famous, and people mistreat him and everything, and he's miserable, miserable. And there's a huge, brightly lit, almost blue-white stage lit. And it looks like, and I think it might be, a boxing arena. And everyone around it is really in a boxing area. And he's walking, he's going to have, the TVs are there up on that blatant white-blue stage over there. And he's walking through the path toward that stage. And on either side of him is this audience. Well, you know how Fellini likes to make people look. It's like a bad dream you're having, nightmarish, but beautiful. I will fuck your mind and steal the babies.
I love it.
As he walks, he's looking at these audience members, looking up and look up, and they look up, and they look up. And here's a white face, with a terribly screaming red lipstick. And here's another clown face. And I'm telling you, I went up. I mean, I got high. I left my body, and looking at this thing, just... You know, when you have someone with you in a room, and they carry with them in this moment all the things that you've experienced together in the past. And they have a certain color lipstick on. And the light hits their hair and eyes in a certain way. They're very real. They're really there. And as a listener, as someone looking at them, in fact, you aren't anything or nothing. There are a couple times in my life, three times, where I forgot I was. I completely forgot I was. I was a child, well, I was 12, and I was in acting class, and they had a little banquet for some people. It was during the day, though. And my acting teacher and a woman were talking to each other, and I was listening. And they turned to look at me. What are they looking at? You know what they're looking at? Oh! And I remember, I'm here, I remember. Dear Bottomless Pit, I wake up in a deep search for intent and belief in myself. But the day is intense, and death driven with some euphoria. I'm thinking now, if I ever want your opinion, I'll give it to you over and over. Like, Egyptians fucking the crocodiles. That's my mind now, too. Like Egyptians fucking the crocodiles, and that's my mind now, too. There's a string shooting out from the back of my mind. It's behind me, and living. I can't see it. I've just heard about it. No one knows how long it is or how far it goes, including me. It tows a star shielding my back. As we accelerate indefinitely. We move so fast, this star might actually be pulling me forward, guiding me from the front. I pretend like I don't know the difference, but I do. Eternally is very eternally. Eternity is very okay. Dear Bottomless Pit, I need you here to undo me. I wake up in a deep search for intent and belief in myself. But the day is intense, driven with some euphoria. I'm thinking now, I've never been bored until this moment. And this moment is gone forever. Over and over. That's my mind now, too. Like Egyptians fucking the crocodiles, and that's my mind now, too. Got a strong sense of sense. And in this case, Not liking it says more about you than liking it. I say this. Before you kill me, make sure it's dead. I look at it all for a second. I'm finally slow enough. I go to sleep with worry and fantasy. Watching. By the way, I don't whisper.
It's the saddest thing that I have to
numb the truth
when my dreams come true. Fucking lame, actually. One thought at a time. I see.
People love to confess and design the confession. Designer non-confessions. 6 walls of sex. Now that there is nothing else to it, we can move on. Yep. Specialized. I am specialized. I've been smoking myself again, too. Love you. Fuck you. Now. Crawl into hell.
Is there nothing that serious, is it?